Hello students, welcome to this live class. Today we are going to solve GATE 2017 computer science paper live, and in this live stream you will find the solution of set 1 computer science paper. This is our test interface, whatever you are seeing on your screen. This is our live test interface. To access this free practice test, you can sign up to getlectures.com for free and practice GATE papers as a mock test. Okay. So let's start with the first part of paper, that is general aptitude part. So in this part we have 10 questions, and first question is after Rajendra Chola returned from his voyage to Indonesia, he wished to visit the temple in Thanjavur. So which of the following should be there in place of in this blank? So was wishing or is wishing wished or had wished? So first thing to notice is the main clause is in the past. Okay, past tense, you can see returned. So this is in past tense. Whenever the main clause is in past or past perfect tense, the sub, that is sub clause. Okay, sub clause should also be in the past. Okay, past or past perfect tense. So as it, this is in past tense, this main clause in past tense, this should also be in past tense. So we cannot use was wishing or is wishing, we have to use wished or had wished. So the one of the main suitable is wished. So this should be the answer for this question. So C is the answer for this question. Question number 2 says, research in the workplace reveals that people work for many reasons. Money besides, beside money, money besides, or besides money. So definitely money besides and money beside cannot be the answer. Okay, so we can use noun after the beside, not before the beside. So beside word can be used for two purposes. First, for as a noun. Okay, first it can be used after noun or it can be used after non-noun. So as we can see from here, so money is not a noun, so which of these should be used? So beside is used as a preposition. Okay, beside is a preposition, besides is also a preposition, both of them beside word. Okay, beside and besides, both of these are prepositions. So but they have different meanings. Beside without s has a different meaning, and besides has a different meaning. Beside is always used after the noun. Okay, beside can only be used before the noun, so you can say he was sitting beside me. Okay, you cannot say he was sitting besides me. Okay, so beside can only be used before noun, and besides has a different meaning. Besides means except. Okay, you can say except. The different meaning of besides is except. And because money is not a noun, so use of word beside after money, before money, is not valid. Okay, so this is also not valid because money is not a noun. Beside can only be used before the noun. Okay, besides can be used for different purpose. So the correct answer for this question should be D. So D is the right answer for this question. Now question number 3. In question number 3, Rahul, Murli, Srinivas and Arul are seated around a square table. Okay, so we have a square table and 4 people are sitting. Rahul is sitting to the left of Murli. Okay, Rahul is sitting, this is Murli, and the Rahul is sitting on the left of Murli. Srinivas is sitting to the right of Arul. Okay, Srinivas is sitting to the right of Arul. Let's say Arul is here. So right of Arul is this. So Srinivas is sitting here. Which of the following pairs are seated opposite to each other? Rahul and Murli. Rahul and Murli are not opposite, are Murli and Srinivas. Arul and Rahul. So Rahul and Murli are not opposite. Srinivas and Arul, no, they are not opposite. Srinivas and Murli, yes, they are opposite. Srinivas and Murli are opposite. Srinivas and Rahul, they are not opposite. So correct answer for this question is C, that is Srinivas and Murli. So question number 4, दिस क्वेश्चन सेज फाइंड द स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर सच दैट वाई इंटू वन एक्स 162 इज अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर, परफेक्ट क्यूब. ओके सॉरी, परफेक्ट क्यूब. वॉट इज परफेक्ट स्क्वायर और ए परफेक्ट क्यूब इफ अ वेरिएबल विद एन एक्सपोनेंट हैज इवन एक्सपोनेंट. ओके फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव अ इवन एक्सपोनेंट. ओके लेट्स से वी हैव 2 टू द पावर और एनी नंबर वी हैव इफ एनी नंबर हैज अ इवन एक्सपोनेंट देन वी से दिस इज अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल 1 टू द पावर 2 इज 1, 2 टू द पावर 2 इज 4, सो 4 इज ए परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. 3 टू द पावर 2 9, 9 इज ए परफेक्ट स्क्वायर, बट 3 टू द पावर 3 दैट इज 27 इज नॉट ए परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. दिस इज ए परफेक्ट क्यूब एक्चुअली. वॉट इज परफेक्ट क्यूब? इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टॉक अबाउट द परफेक्ट स्क्वायर यू कैन से 1, 4, 9, 16, ऑल ऑफ दीज आर परफेक्ट स्क्वायर्स. इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द परफेक्ट क्यूब, इफ अ वेरिएबल विद एन एक्सपोनेंट हैज एन एक्सपोनेंट विच इज डिविजिबल बाय 3. ओके इफ द एक्सपोनेंट इज डिविजिबल बाय 3, लेट्स से वी हैव अ नंबर एंड वी हैव एक्सपोनेंट, देन एक्सपोनेंट शुड बी डिविजिबल बाय 3, देन वी कैन से दिस नंबर इज परफेक्ट क्यूब. ओके फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव अ नंबर लेट्स से 3 टू द पावर 3 विच मीन्स 27. 27 इज अ परफेक्ट क्यूब. वाई इट इज अ परफेक्ट क्यूब? बिकॉज द एक्सपोनेंट इज डिविजिबल बाय 3. और 3 टू द पावर 9 इज अ परफेक्ट क्यूब. द नंबर विच इज हियर इज अ परफेक्ट क्यूब. और लेट्स से 2 टू द पावर 3 इक्वल्स टू 8. 8 इज अ परफेक्ट क्यूब. सो लाइक दिस वॉट वैल्यू शुड बी मल्टीप्लाइड विद 162 सो दैट इट इज अ परफेक्ट क्यूब. सो वाई इंटू 162 और यू कैन से वाई इंटू 2 इंटू 81. ओके यू कैन राइट 162 एज वाई इंटू 2 इंटू 81 और यू कैन से 2 इंटू 9 इंटू 9. सो वी हैव 9 टू द पावर 2 एंड 2 टू द पावर 1. वी हैव टू ऐड 2 टू द पावर 2. ओके वी हैव टू ऐड 2 टू द पावर 2 टू मेक इट 2 टू द पावर 3. ओके व्हेन दिस बिकम्स 2 टू द पावर 3 दिस विल बी अ परफेक्ट क्यूब. व्हेन एंड मल्टीप्लाइंग बाय 9, 9 बिकम्स दिस बिकम्स 2 9 टू द पावर 3 विच मीन्स दिस विल बिकम लाइक दिस 2 इंटू 2 इंटू 2 इंटू 9 इंटू 9 इंटू 9. वी हैव दिस नंबर फॉर नाउ वी हैव दिस नंबर 9 इंटू 9 इंटू 2 दैट इज 9 इंटू 9 इंटू 2. वी हैव टू ऐड 9 2 एंड 2 दैट इज 4 इंटू 9 36. 36 शुड बी मल्टीप्लाइड विद 162 देन दिस विल बिकम परफेक्ट क्यूब. ओके दिस विल बिकम ए परफेक्ट क्यूब नंबर. सो आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज 36 दैट इज डी. So we have next question, and in this question the probability that a k digit number does not contain the digit 0, 5 or 9. We have to compose a number which cannot have a digit 0, 5 or 9. For example, if we have k equals to 1, that is let's say one digit number. If I have one digit number, this is my one digit number, and this number can be one of the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. These are the numbers I can use here. So this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so it has 7 choice. Okay, if we have one digit number, it has 7 choice. Either it can be 1, it can be 2 or 3 or 4 or 6 or 7 or 8. Total possibilities are 10. Okay, there can be 10 digits on this place, but favorable cases are 7. According to the question, there cannot be 0, 5 or 9 in the number. Okay, all number can be like this. So probability is 0.7 if I have one digit number. If I have a two digit number like this, then we have 7 choices here and 7 choices here, because 0, 5 or 9 cannot be used. We cannot use 0, 5 or 9. We can only use these digits. So 7 choice here and 7 choice here. So in two digit number, so we have 7 into 7 and favorable cases are 100. Okay, 10 into 10. That is total possible combination can be 100, but out of 100 we can use only 49 combinations. Okay, 49 by 100, or you can say 0.49. this is the probability of a number which is not containing 0.59 and have two digit. So this can be written as 0.7 to the power 2. Like this, if you have three digit number, then you will have 0.7 to the power 3. If you have a k digit number, then you will have k digits like this, and all the digits have, all the places have 7 choices. You can use all the numbers from 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, but cannot use 0, 5 or 9. So you can say this will be 7 to the power k divided by 10 to the power k, or you can say 7 by 10 to the power k, or you can say 0.7 to the power k. So the probability of a number, of a k digit number which does not contain the digit 0, 5 or 9 is 0.7 to the power k. That is option number 3. So next question is, the hold of the nationalist imagination on our colonial past is such that anything adequately or importantly nationalist is just not history. Okay, so what it is saying in this sentence? It is saying that we try to overlook facts of history which is not in favor of our nationalism interest, which means you can look at this sentence. The hold of the nationalist imagination on our colonial past is such that anything adequately or importantly nationalist is just not history, is just not a history, which means we are overlooking the facts of history which is not in favor of our nationalism interest. So let's look at the option. Which of these following statements best reflect the author's opinion? Nationalists are highly imaginative. Okay, this is not appropriate. History is viewed through the filter of nationalism, which means we are looking at everything through the filter of nationalism, and this is more suitable to this sentence. Okay, what we are doing is we are overlooking the fact of history which is not actually in favor of our nationalism interest. So option B is the correct answer for this question. Question number 7. Question number 7 says, six people are seated around a table, circular table. There are at least two men and two women. At least two men and two women. There are at least three right-handed persons. At least three right-handed persons, which means there can be at most three left-handed persons. Okay, at most three left-handed, because at least three right-handed persons are there. Every woman has a left-handed person to her immediate right. None of the women are right-handed, which means all of the women are left-handed. Okay, women are left-handed. All of the women are left-handed. The number of women on the table is. So what is the number of women on the table? Let's say this is your table and we have six person on this table. P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6. Okay, choose any two women randomly. Okay, let me choose all two women which are not adjacent to each other. Okay, let's say P1 is a woman and P3 is a woman. Let's say P1 is a woman and P3 is a woman. These two are the women. It is saying there are at least two men and two women. At least two women. So let's say P1 is a woman and P3 is a woman. I'm taking at least. So this question is saying every woman has a left-handed person to her immediate right. Okay, the immediate right of P1 is this, which means obviously women are left-handed. This is given. None of the women are right-handed, which means this woman is left-handed, and that means every person to the right of this woman is also a left-handed. Every woman has a left-handed person to her immediate right. Okay, to her immediate right we have a left-handed person, and P3 is also a woman, so this is also left-handed. And the immediate right of P3 is also left-handed. So how many left-handed we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. But according to the sentences, we can have only at most three left-handed, because there are at least three right-handed persons already there. We have total six persons, and out of six, at least three right-handed persons are there. That means that we can have at most three left-handed persons. But according to this arrangement, we have four left-handed persons, which is not possible. Okay, so we cannot keep the women's far to each other. We have to keep the women's adjacent to each other. Okay, if you take any woman by in the alternate, if you take woman, that will be a wrong assumption. So if I take women's adjacent to each other, let's say this is P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 and P6. Let's say P4 is woman and P5 is also a woman, which means this is left-handed and P5 is also left-handed. Then P6 is also left-handed because the immediate right of a woman is also left-handed. Okay, every woman has a left-handed person to her immediate right. This is true. We have at most three left-handed persons, which means either P1, P2, P3 are right-handed. So we can have only two women. If I make P1 as a woman, then this will be left-handed and the immediate right of this will also be left-handed. That will become five left-handed, which is not possible according to this question. So we can have only two women which are actually adjacent to each other, which are sitting adjacent to each other. So according to this arrangement, we have only two women, at most two women. So answer to this question is asking the number of women at the table is how many. So we have only two women on this table which are adjacent to each other. So let's look at the next question. And this question says the expression x plus y minus x minus y by 2 is equal to what? We have two options to solve this question. First is either you can directly put the values of x and y, any arbitrary value, and check for the values. For example, let's put x equals to 2 and y equals to 3. So expression will become x plus y will become 5 minus 2 minus 3 will divide by 2 will become 5 minus this will be 1 divided by 2, that is 4 by 2, 2. So this expression is giving the minimum of these two. Okay, if you put the values of x equals to 2 and y equals to 3, you can see it is giving the minimum value. But how to solve this question systematically? For example, if we have a mod x minus y, if the value of this is greater than 0, okay, if the value of this is greater than 0, which means x is actually greater than y. In this case, x is greater than y. If x minus y is greater than 0, you can write this as x minus y simply. Okay, because if the difference is giving the positive value, which means x is greater. Okay, if x is less than y, which then it will give negative value, which will be less than 0. So according to this assumption, x minus y, if x minus y is greater than 0, then the solution of this is x minus y. If x minus y x mod x minus y is less than 0, then we can say actually y is greater than x. Okay, and the solution of this will be minus x minus y, because the solution will give the result in minus, or you can say y minus x. This will be y minus x. So if the value of this difference is greater than 0, then x is greater than y, and the value of difference is less than 0, that means y is greater than x. That's why it is giving negative value. It will give negative value only in one case, when y is greater than x. Okay, so this is the assumption. Let's try to put these values here. If I put x minus y, okay, if I put x plus y, and is in place of mod x minus y, let me put x minus y, which means I am assuming that x is greater than y. If I'm assuming that x is greater than y, then the solution of x minus y is bracket x minus y, okay, divided by 2. This will give x plus y minus x plus y, which means this will be 2y by 2, that is y. This was the assumption that x is less than y, x is greater than y, which means y is less than x. This assumption is giving that it is giving minimum. Okay, if I take this assumption, that is y is greater than x, then the solution of mod x minus y will be y minus x. Okay, if y is greater than x, then this will give x plus y minus y plus x divided by 2, that is 2x by 2. It is always giving me the minimum value. Okay, whichever is minimum of y and x is giving the as an answer. So in this case, y was greater than x, then the solution was x. When x was greater than y, then solution was y. So it is giving the minimum. So answer to this question is minimum of xy, that is second option. So let's look at the second question. Next question is Arun, Gulab, Neil and Shweta must choose one shirt each from a pile of four shirts colored red, pink, blue and white. So we have four clerks and four people. Out of these four people, we have some dislikes. For example, we have Arun, Gulab. How they will choose the colors? Neil, and then we have Shweta. And we have four colors, that is red, pink, blue and white. Arun dislikes red, which means Arun never chooses red. And Shweta dislikes white, which means Shweta will never choose white. So I can take one person as a base, either Arun or Shweta, and can calculate what are the choices. For example, I will have three choices. If I choose Arun, let's say I'm saying Arun will choose first. Okay, if Arun chooses first, Arun can choose out of these three colors. He cannot choose red. For example, we have case 1. In this case 1, Arun is choosing, let's say, pink. Arun choose pink. Okay, so next Shweta comes. So Shweta have two choices only, pink and blue. Okay, because let's say pink is already taken by Arun. Okay, Arun has already taken the pink. Then Shweta cannot take white and pink is already taken. So Shweta can take either red or blue. So Shweta has two choices. Then Gulab can choose from two colors, either white or one of the colors which Shweta left. So Gulab has two choices. Then Neil comes. Neil have only one choice because only one color is left. One is already taken by Shweta, one is already taken by Arun, and one is taken by Neil. So we have four choices in this case. Case 2 is, let's say, Arun choose blue. If Arun choose blue, what will happen? Shweta will have two choices. Okay, either Shweta can choose pink or red because blue is already taken by Arun and Shweta cannot take white. Okay, so Shweta can take either red or can take pink. So two choices for Shweta. Then Gulab. We have a Gulab. Gulab can take out of two colors. Okay, because one is already taken by Arun and one is taken by Shweta. We have two colors left. So Gulab have two choices. Now Gulab picks one color. Neil have only one choice. Then case 3. Arun choose white. If Arun choose white, what will happen? The Shweta dislikes color white and white is already taken by Arun. So Shweta now has three choices. Okay, Shweta have three choices. Shweta can take red, pink or blue. So Shweta will have three choices. Then Gulab will come and Gulab will have two choices. Okay, because one is already taken by Arun and one is taken by Shweta. Then Neil have one choice. So total number of solution can be 4 plus 4 plus 6. These are the choices, these are the ways in which they can choose the colors. That is 14. So D is the right answer for this question. So we have three cases and one of these cases can be there. So that's why we are using plus. Okay, one of these cases can occur. That's why 4 or 4 or 6. That means 14. Question number 10, and this question says a contour line joins locations having the same height above the mean sea level. The following is a contour plot of a geographical region. Contour lines are shown at 25 meter interval in this plot. If in a flood the water level rises to 525 meter, which of the following villages PQRST get submerged? Okay, so the condition to get submerged, the value should be less than 525. This is given, water level rises to 525 meter. So we can write this: to get submerged, the value should be less than 525. Okay, this is given. To get submerged, the value should be 5, because the water level rises to 525 meter, less than 525. Okay, so let's see what is the condition of P. So as we can see, P is between 550 and 600. Okay, 550 and 600. So P is between 550 and 600. Then let's look at the Q. Okay, Q is at this position and Q is between 550 and 525. Okay, this is 550 and 525. So Q is between 550 and 525. Then let's look at the R. We have R here and R is between 500 and 450. Okay, R is between 450 and 500. So R is between 500 and 450. Then we have S, and S is here. S can be seen. We have S between 450 and 425. Okay, S is between 450 and 425. So S is between 450 and 425. The condition to get submerged is 525 meter. Okay, then we have T, village T, and T is at this position. So T is between 525 and 500. This is 500 and 525. So T is between 525 and 500. So which of the, which, this is very logical question and this is simple if you can apply the logic here. So P, Q, R, S, T have these positions. So which of these have the value less than 525? Which of the following is less than 525? So as we can see, R, P and Q, P and Q are above 525. Okay, P, Q are above 525. So we have to find those values which are actually less than 525. As you can see, R is between 450 and 500. Okay, it is greater than 500 and less than 450. So it is between, it is coming in this range, 525. And as you can see, between 450 and 425, this is below 525. Obviously, this is below 525. And T, as you can see, is between 500 and 525. This is also coming in this range, 525. So RST are coming in this range, so they will be submerged. RST will be submerged after the flood. The sea level rises to 525 meters. So according to options, option C is correct for this question.